This is what happens. We've been doctoring down to nothing. This is colony collapse right here.
An alarming die-off of honeybees has beekeepers fighting for survival and crop growers wondering whether bees will be available to pollinate their crops. Researchers are scrambling to find answers to what they're calling colony collapse disorder. If you want to grow fruits, vegetables, and nuts here in the Central Valley, honeybees are essential.
Well, the honeybees are used to pollinate one-third of the food we eat in this country every day and every year. And this time last year, the beekeepers started noticing that their bees were simply disappearing, sometimes all of them. And what has now become a global bee die-off is still a mystery to both the keepers and the scientists.
We have team coverage tonight. KCRA3's Chris Riva went to UC Davis, where researchers are trying to find out what's causing the die-off.
The buzz surrounding honeybees is called CCD, colony collapse disorder.
The adult bees from honeybee colony just simply get up and fly away.
Described as a phenomenon where millions of bees mysteriously disappear.
There doesn't seem to be any reason for them to go, but they just leave.
CCD is bad news for farmers who often hire beekeepers to pollinate their crops.
It's estimated that it would cost $90 billion to manually pollinate our crops here in the United States. That's why beekeepers are putting a lot of pressure on places like UC Davis to determine why the bees continue to disappear.
The phenomenon probably is happening because the honeybees that are leaving are ill, sick. I can look inside and I can find the tracheal system.
At UC Davis, Professor Eric Musen believes the bees are ill because of malnutrition, parasitic mites, and infections.
So nutrition isn't the only answer, but it is one way to begin to have your bees weakened so that when these other things impinge upon them, they can overwhelm them.
A very sick bee, yeah.
Sue Kobe's specialty is bee breeding, showing us this bee that was kicked out of the colony because of a wing virus.
So this is part of the puzzle of CCD.
A puzzle scientists are diligently trying to solve.
For the CCD issue, it's very complex. It's a lot of different things going on, and we can't put our finger on one particular thing. But I think basically, if you look at agriculture in general, we're in a lot of trouble.
It's continuing right now. I know there are examples of individuals suffering the same losses this year. Whether it will be as substantial, I don't really know.
In Davis, Chris Riva, KCRA 3 reports.
This phenomenon is particularly important for California's $1.5 billion almond growing industry. Almond growers rely almost entirely on honeybees to pollinate their crop, and their value is estimated at $1.5 billion.
People who make their living off honeybees are already suffering. Our team coverage continues. KCRA3's Sharakina Sham shows us how beekeepers could lose everything if scientists can't unravel the mystery.
This is what happens. We've been doctoring down to nothing. This is colony collapse right here.
For 20 years, Louise Rosberg has been keeping honeybees. Never has she had so few. It started, she says, in December of last year. She began to see fewer and fewer bees. She wondered whether she'd have enough to rent to almond growers to pollinate their crop. And the problem was even bigger than she first thought.
I've talked to beekeepers from Chowchilla, from Chico area, from Napa area. They've even written papers, it's in the papers and stuff. They have just completely lost their bees.
You can really see the loss when you look out at all of these boxes. Right now, there are a few bees flying around here, but every one of these 200 boxes used to be full. These days, when Louise Rosberg looks out here, she likens it to a growing graveyard. Beekeepers have had to bear another sting, too. Right now, there is no federal aid to help them. Unlike the citrus freeze of last winter, the beekeepers' plight is not considered a natural disaster. Rosberg knows scientists are trying to find out what's causing the death of honeybees, but she figures if she goes out of business first,
you don't have bees to rent, you don't make money, you lose your home.
The answers from researchers won't matter much to her. In Stanislaus County, Sharakina Shams, KCRA 3 reports.
A spokesman for Modesto area Congressman Dennis Cardoza says there's no government plan specifically geared to help beekeepers dealing with colony collapse. But the 2007 Farm Bill being debated by the U.S. Senate does include help for honey producers. Many beekeepers have simply taken to drastically increasing the cost of renting out their hives to growers. And here are some facts you may not know about bees and honey. Honey is one of the oldest foods in existence. It was found in the tomb of King Tut and is still edible since honey never spoils. Bees have four wings that stroke more than 11,000 times per minute, thus making their distinctive buzz. A bee flies at a rate of 12 miles an hour. An average worker bee makes only about 1/2 teaspoon of honey in its whole lifetime.